when I was born, my father had a hobby shop, and it just was always around me, always a time that he was in the hobby industry and in the hobby as a hobby. And for me, that was, it's a constant.
You're gonna land it?
You hear this term generational in families and RC, but I don't think there's many cases where it is so focused as it is in the Machinji family.
Sav, awesome landing.
What does flying mean to me? It's been my life forever. I've never worked another trade. I've always been in the RC industry. It's what's molded my life for the last probably 42 years, jeez. It's always been something that I've been doing as a passion, as work, as a means to provide for my family. So I think I'm in one of those very rare situations where flying means almost everything.
Go for it.
It's certainly been something that's brought us together, for sure, as a hobby. We talk about it, we have a passion about it. Zav and I especially, we're in it pretty much 24/7. Yeah, it's in our blood.
What's it like to fly with my dad?
Good effort.
It's fun. It's always something different every time. I love watching him fly. He always makes me nervous because he gets really low sometimes. And he always amazes me when he flies. I've just always wondered how he's so good and so calm. I always get panicky when I get low to the ground. I try not to show it, but I do. And I'm like, oh, I gotta push out of this inverted light. But he just keeps going.
When Zavi first started flying, he was very young, like I was. He was probably about 4 or 5. He took to the hobby, he joined me at the field. He showed an interest in flying, but the attention span just wasn't there.
Be careful, Zav. Gotta get it back in this field. You're gonna get it over that hedge.
He'd learned to fly a basic two-channel aircraft, and then I think it just got too much for him. At that stage, I was like, okay, you know, I don't want to be that dad, so I let him go.
He's very encouraging. He wants me to make it my life, but he's not pushy, not whatsoever. How I started out, he wasn't pushy at all. He would offer to bring me to the field.
And out of the blue one day, he decided that he wanted to fly RC again. So I don't know what it was, but I could see that he was much more focused on the hobby. So I was very involved in the years between his 6th and probably 10th year. And then I noticed very clearly that my involvement was probably hindering him in a sense. He needed to find his own way, learn his own things, learn from others. So I took a step back and
then one day it clicked. So he wasn't pushy whatsoever. He's just the right spot, the sweet spot of just, he helps me out when I need help.
I can watch him learning from some of the greats in the hobby, and it's quite a different perspective as a parent.
He teaches me. He says, this is what you did wrong, and it helps me a lot, and he's always there to fix my mistakes because I break a lot of stuff sometimes.
It's not so much a coaching thing of saying, do this, do that, pull up, left rudder, right rudder. You know, he's way beyond that in terms of what I can teach him. So yeah, it's more of a peripheral coach, if you like, to the whole hobby.
Behind the sticks, I'm in my zone, you know. I'm doing my thing, I'm comfortable, I'm doing what I love and I'm passionate about and I want to make my life around.
The thumbs are one thing, the head is another. Having it together in terms of how you present yourself, how you present the aircraft, how you help others, how you interact with others. He's got a lot to learn there, which is perfectly understandable. He's 17.
It amazes me how he can like help everybody, and he's always there, always a helping hand at every event. He always flies other people's stuff more than his own just because he's that busy helping people.
Yeah, all he needs now is the experience, that's all. Nothing else. I mean, he's already far exceeding me, what I was doing at his age, so if he carries on this trajectory, he'll far exceed what I am in terms of a hobby level pilot.
What I like to achieve would probably be to inspire other people to do it, because it's a really fun hobby and it just takes a little bit of time. You don't have to be as good as the best, but bring out a small little plane, you fly it, land it, don't crash it, you're good to go. But I just like to get people into it and say that's really cool, because it is a cool hobby.
between Xavier and I, who's the better pilot? This is probably the simplest question you've asked me and the easiest to answer, and I'm not just saying this, it's him by a long way.
Who's the better pilot? My dad, 100%. Everyone's like, oh, you're catching up. I'm not.
If we're talking about natural ability, thumb skills, at the age of 17, when I look back and think about what I was doing at 17 versus what he's doing, it's mind-blowing.
He's more confident than I am. I lack confidence. Yeah, I can do the same stuff he does, but I have to do it 10 times higher than he can.
The difference between capability is stratospheres apart. I mean, the kid is doing stuff with his thumbs right now that I probably never did at my peak.
And he's just more versatile too. He has better energy management. There's just so many things, like a list of that he does better than me. I'm getting there, but I'm nowhere near him yet.
Yeah, he's a long way ahead. It's super, super cool to be able to share a hobby, and it's certainly kept me enthused and focused on it a lot longer and a lot closer than I would have been, I think, without him. So I'm super grateful of that, and I look forward to many years, and who knows what he will choose to do, whether he'll choose to take a sabbatical from it or not, whatever he decides to do, I'm cool with that. But I look forward to having those moments that I've had with my dad, which is, you know, that we get to just spend time alone on a flying field together, no air show, no event, no particularly fancy airplanes, just sharing our passion for the one hobby that has brought us together for a lot of time over the years. So yeah, it'd be cool if Xavier and I can experience that in time to come.
Oh, first to hit the fence and the scoreboard loses. You won that one. Which way are you going through it?